आई एम साई जितने वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल साई टेक। इन टुडेस वी विल ट्राई टू कंपेयर द जी कैम कैमरा पिक्स वर्सेस द स्टॉक कैमरा फ्रॉम द एम आई 11X डिवाइस। एज यू कैन सी फ्रेंड्स, सो लॉट ऑफ यूजर्स डिड आस्क मी दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट हाउ इज अ जी कैम एक्सपीरियंस इन दिस फोन एंड इफ यू कंपेयर विद द डिफॉल्ट स्टॉक कैमरा पिक्स इज देर एनी मच इंप्रूवमेंट और नॉट। सो राइट नाउ आई डिड ट्राई द जी कैम इंस्टॉलेशन इन दिस फोन एंड इट वॉज वर्किंग सक्सेसफुली। एंड इन केस इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डाउनलोड द जी कैम, सो मेक श्योर टू जॉइन माई टेलीग्राम ग्रुप एज वेल। द एपीके आई विल बी अपलोडिंग इन द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप। एंड इफ यू आर new to my channel, make sure to subscribe and stay tuned for more videos on this MI 11X as well. So don't forget to check the links in description. So let me try to quickly open the GCam application, friends. As you can see, the GCam application is completely good, and even you do get all the features like the night mode, night sight mode, portrait mode, camera and the video and the more option. You do get the panorama and the photo sphere option as well, as you can see here. And all the options are working perfectly all right in this phone without any kind of problem. As you can see friends, everything. But right now in this video I'll try to only compare the images which are taken with the stock camera versus the actual GCam camera. So let's see few of the images so which I'll be trying to show you right now. So this is a camera which I shot, which I taken recorded using the stock camera, as you can see friends clearly, using the stock camera in the wide angle lens. And this is a normal GCam, and this is a stock and the GCam, as you can see here in the wide angle lens friends. And this is the normal lens, GCam and the stock. So mostly the GCam is not that performing good in the wide angle, but it's performing great in the normal camera shots if you use. So I did not go take much kind of outdoor shots, but just in basic indoor shots which I thought of taking today. And in case if you are interested in the outdoor shots as well, so make sure to comment below. I'll do my best to go outside and try those shots as well. So these are GCam shots which are taken here, as you can see the clarity and the detail. As you can see here, and this is a normal stock one which I taken by the default camera, and this is a GCam shot which I taken here, and this is a stock one. If you look at the plans, as you can see friends, so which looks kind of good on the GCam. So overall in the GCam slot, only two things are key highlight. So one is the brightness and next is the saturation. These two are the main points for taking camera pics in this GCam as well, as you can see. So same thing goes to this outdoor shot which I have taken here. So let me try to zoom in a little bit more. As you can see friends, the clarity and the saturation levels. So this is a normal stock shot which I have taken, stock camera using. Even this is also good. And this is a normal GCam pick, as you can see, using the GCam which I have taken here. And this is a stock. GCam. And using this gold camera where you will be getting this kind of very good saturation colors, as I said, you can observe in this pic clearly. And this is a normal shot which at night sight. So in this case the complete lighting condition is completely close to 5%, I think, so not much. So this is a night sight which I taken using the gold camera, but I'll try to do separate video on that night mode as well, testing both, so gold cam versus a normal cam. So this is a stock camera which it has taken. So Google camera did produce slightly better results in terms of the night mode shot results, as you can see friends. So definitely I'll do that kind of night mode testing later on as well. So this is just a basic image comparison between both using the gold cam and the normal camera lens. So make sure to comment below your thoughts as well. I'll do the another in detail comparison in the using night mode particularly. That is what I'll try to focus in the next upcoming videos. So that's it friends, this is a quick review, and let me try to even take the normal shot in this kind of studio kind of environment, so you might be able to feel the difference. As you can see, the focusing level as well. Even it's very fast friends, as you can see the snapping also. As you can see it is very fast, and you do get the 109 as well to zoom in, 1.9x zoom, as you can see here. And you can change the lens, so you can zoom up to 10x as well. As you can see 10x, I'm trying to zoom in. Let me need to use a default camera, and this is a default camera with the 10x. So even you can take the shots with the wide angle lens as well, friends, overall. So just now I taken the plant image as well, so let me try to quickly compare two shots. As you can see here, so this with the normal shot, with the G cam shot, this is the clarity, this is how it looks, and this with the stock MI11X camera. So both are kind of close to each other only, but the G cam will produce a slightly better brightness and slightly better saturation colors. So that is what I came into the conclusion after using this for today. And thank you, friends, for watching this video, and for more interesting videos, make sure to subscribe and stay tuned, and see you in the next video, friends. Until then, bye.